Hey up there, it's Dan here, and today what I'm going to be doing is making a pit oven, and I'm going to be doing this with a friend of mine who's going to be joining me, helping me out with this today on behalf of his video blog that he's setting up, and that's Pete. Welcome to my channel, Pete. You alright, mate? He's doing a blog called Forest Bushcraft. Please check him out. I'll stick the link just down there so you can have a look at that. And what we're going to do is we're just going to take you through the stages of how we are going to make our pit oven. We've had a couple of goes at this now. Works out quite well off camera, so fingers crossed it turns out just as good on camera as well. So let's get to it. We need to break it up into stages, show you what you need to do before you actually start cooking. So let's crack on with that. I'll see you in a minute. Right guys, so to dig our hole, what we're going to need is a digging implement, and that's where this thing comes in. So we're going to make ourselves a digging stick. I found a piece of wood that's not rotten. That's obviously important. You need it to be strong. That's just a little bit smaller than my wrist thickness. Something that fits comfortably in my hand is going to be nice and strong. And what we're going to do to make a digging stick, nothing complicated. You're just going to take one edge of it and get your axe or whatever you've got there. And just work it away to a rough point, and that's what you're going to use there to break up the earth. And then once you've broke up the earth, you scoop it out and you've dug yourself down a little bit. You repeat that until you get to the desired depth. So I'm just going to finish this off now, make this look a little bit smoother, probably in fact as well get rid of some of these little notches, knots on the wood as well, just to make it a little bit more comfortable for my hand. Your digging stick doesn't have to be anything elaborate. Don't worry about that, you know, it's all about function really. So I mean, in fairness, if you're struggling for firewood, once you're finished with it, you're always going to burn it, you know. You don't have to keep it forever. So that's the digging stick almost made. I think I'll just neaten this off a little bit and then we'll set to dig in the hole, so I'll see you in a minute. Right then, so now what we've done is we've dug our hole. Then you're going to start lining your hole with the rocks that you've gathered. And if we just look down here, what you'll actually see is there's a hole dug here with rocks already in it. Now this is the oven that we've used previously, and in Mesolithic times this sort of thing would happen very frequently. People return to the same site because it's already been done, it's a lot less effort. But if you were starting from scratch, basically what you want to do is just dig down enough, make sure that you can actually get your meat that you're cooking sort of below the ground level. Okay, that way it's going to retain the most heat itself. And then the next thing you need to focus on is, of course, the rocks that you're going to actually have been using. Now, so if I can show you the two different kinds of rock that we've got here. We've got some sedimentary rock, which is slate, and we've got some igneous rock here. Now, out of the two, you want the igneous rock. It's denser, which means it's going to hold a lot more heat, and it's also a lot less prone to shattering. Which is the problem with sedimentary rock like this. What we might find is that we'll have a few pops of the rocks breaking in the fire, as long as we're not too close. Hopefully that shouldn't be much of an issue. By the time the meat goes in there, everything will have settled down, temperature will have equalised, so we shouldn't really see any problems while the meat's in there. And how we're going to line our wall is, you want to start off going right the way around the edge, scraping it out. Get your rocks fairly flat, because what you want is a big surface reflecting the heat back towards the meat that you're going to be cooking. You can use a bit of soil to push it in to help it stand up relatively straight, and you're going to build this around. And then once you've got that completed, we'll start getting the fire going inside. So that's the next stage. We'll get this finished and we'll move along to what's coming up afterwards. Cheers for now. Right then guys, so we've got everything prepared now. We've found all of our rocks and we've dug our hole, and what we've just got inside the hole there is just a little base of really dry wood that we've actually brought here today just to help the fire burn a little easier, and especially because you don't have any airflow coming from underneath because you're making a fire in a pit. It is essential to build your fire correctly. Take your time, get it right, because it's not going to light as well as it would if you were building it above ground. So just bear that in mind, folks. So we're going to get the fire going now, and then I think once the fire's hot enough to accept the rocks, and that will probably come back to you then. So I'll see you then, guys. Right then, guys. So as you can see down here, we've got our fire going now. It's burning pretty well, considering it's in a pit. Maybe give it a little blow. Make sure it's getting plenty of oxygen. And you can see there, we've put a couple of rocks on top of it now. What we're going to hopefully achieve in a little while is the fact that we'll have some more wood on top of those rocks, So by the time that the fire's burnt down after a couple of hours, it's just a case of fishing these hot rocks back out, and basically we want to get them to a point of being red hot before it's actually ready to use as an oven. So while that fire's going to carry on burning, we'll probably pop a couple more rocks on there. There goes one of those bits of slate by the sounds of it. We're going to go off and find some moss to go on top of the fire once it's burned down. So I'll pop back to you when we've found some suitable moss. See you in a minute. Right guys, so me and Foz are just working as a bit of a team at the moment, just to gather up all the moss that we're going to need to actually go on top of our pit oven. So we've come across this dry stone wall. As you can see, it's absolutely covered in moss. Now ideally you want to get it as thick as you can, because this is going to provide an insulative layer. It's also going to provide moisture to the meat, which helps to keep it nice and tender. And if you can, try and get big chunks like this, and what you want to do is just carefully sort of just peel it back, trying to keep it as whole as possible. And especially when you're taking it off rocks, it's a little bit easier to do that. So as you can see there, got a nice big piece of it there. It's breaking up a little bit, and you're just going to chuck in a good couple of layers of this stuff on top of it before you're going to finally cover your pit oven in dirt. So we're just going to carry on picking up good bits like this for a moment till we've got enough, and we'll then move on to the next stage. I'll see you then. Right guys, so we've had our fire burning for a couple of hours now. We've just shifted a few embers over here to create a second fire, which is actually where we're going to cook some bannock bread, and we're going to bring a couple of things up to the boil on the water. This is all going to be really quick. We're going to need to move all of the rocks just out to the side, so we're just going to flick them out to the side, scrape the embers through quickly over to that fire so they don't lose too much heat. Then what we're going to do next, Foz?
Once all the embers are emptied, we've got a selection of wet sticks here, some moss over here, and then the leftover sod that we've dug up. So once it's empty, we chuck the meat in, throw the hot stone on top of it, then as quickly as we can we get these wet sticks, lay them over the top of the pit, then cover that with the wet moss that we've covered, and then cover the moss with the dirt and the sod that's left over, which will create a nice airtight seal and will keep all of the heat in for the next couple of hours, because it's going to take us about an hour and a half to 2 hours for the joint of meat to cook.
What you're going to notice as well, when we put the final layer on top, we're going to have to work again a little bit quickly just to plug any little gaps where you'll see smoke and steam coming through. Once you've stopped those gaps, you know you've got your pit oven airtight, you know, then you can leave it to cook. So without further ado, let's set to. Okay. Red hot stones there. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know whether you can see on the camera, but our stones are literally glowing red hot now.
I can feel the heat from this.
It's putting out a fair amount of heat, actually.
Glad I've got these digging sticks.
Set fire to the cameraman there.
Yeah. It's all right, we try and go for cameramen relatively quickly.
Hang on.
On my channel, mate. There
so we go. Give that a good scrape. Okay. Are we going to put some faces up? Oh, we're going to do them on the fire.
Do those on the fire.
Fires, I reckon, yeah.
Yeah. Well, we could chuck the taters in here. Got the foil wrapped and ready to go now.
Right, that's good to get the meat in at that.
Oh,
that's one exploding stone.
That's what they sound like when they go. Right.
One joint of beef.
Go on, mate, you do the honours.
And we'll get the stones back on top.
Yeah, it's sizzling away. That's how we know we've got it hot enough.
You can flip that round off.
Get that out of the way there. Just a case of getting as much contact with the stones as possible onto the meat there. Let's just get that one down in there.
Right. Oh, I can smell the meat cooking already.
Need any more sticks there, Foz?
No, we're all good for sticks.
Okay. Right, get the moss on.
So,
moss time. So what you need to do is good bed of this.
So the wet keeps gives you a nice airtight seal. And then this lot starts to cap it then. Now, quite a lot of the time when you're doing this, you end up, you don't actually have enough of this sod left over from where you've dug, because it actually is, because as you can see, it's starting to form a mound. You end up with a larger surface area than what you started with. So you get it initially on, stop most of the smoke coming out, because the smoke shows you where you're getting air coming through. And then once that's done, you can kind of slow down a bit and collect some more to cover it up with.
Yeah,
I mean, but we actually seem to be doing all right this time, don't we?
We're not doing too bad. I mean, I suppose if you look over there, we're going to be making some beef jerky in a little while. And I think under there, there's another patch where we've just dug up some of these sods.
So
there's a couple of little gaps there.
A couple of bits. You're always going to get a few little bits of smoke and steam escaping. But all that does is kind of make you hungry.
Yeah.
As you can smell the meat.
Well, you can't. We fortunately can. So sorry about that, guys. There we are.
There we go.
I think.
One buried thing of meat.
That's one completely
pickled
in there, maybe a little bit just at the back edge there.
That's a red hot stone.
Yeah, don't be picking up the red hot stones.
Just kind of chuck this over there safely.
There we
go.
Right, okay. So meet that size, probably about 2 hours. And then we're just going to, again, quickly shift that over when we think the meat's ready. So, in the meantime, we're going to leave that cooking. We're going to crack to with some other stuff. Cheers for watching, guys.
Thanks, see you guys.
Right, guys, so it's been, what would you say, Foz? Probably about hour 50?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Closer to 2 hours.
Almost 2 hours, so.
It's 5 to 4 now, so.
Right, and yeah, we're starting to lose light, so I think we'll get it out. Now, you put your hand over there, you push it down, you'll start to feel it gets a little warm. You can see that it's a little bit steam.
You can see steam coming out, can't you?
Yeah. So I think, mate, let's dig in.
Then. So just be careful, because there's quite a lot of steam coming out there. Like.
Yeah, what you're going to feel is as soon as you start moving the top layers, it gets very hot very quick. Yeah, that's starting to get hot.
That's actually really hot.
Yeah. There we are. Down to the bottom there.
Right, the best thing to do there is actually if you just
get kind of... digging stick time, I think.
Yeah.
So we kept our digging sticks, we didn't chuck them on the fire.
Lift some of them out of the way, a little bit this way.
There we go, right. So we know where the meat is. Look at that.
It's well cooked, isn't it?
Look at that. Beautiful.
It's weird, you can like hear how hot the rocks are still.
Yeah.
And there's only one way of doing this, mate.
Beautiful.
There we go. You see that's cooked with a bit of charcoal on the outside, but we don't worry about that.
No, that can be knocked
off. There you go.
Right.
Let's put it onto a plate.
Let's
cut it
move over to a mess tin. I'm going to get a mouthful of string. There we are. Oh yes.
Guys,
I'd like
gorgeous.
You to just have a look in there. Look at that, and this meat is so beautifully tender. Look at that. Cameraman, would you like a little piece?
I'll have a taste, I think.
A little piece, I'll tell you what.
Cameraman gets the first taste, I think.
I think he does, doesn't he? For all his hard work. There you go, cameraman. Straight in there. Straight in the pie hole.
Oh.
That is amazing. That is so good. Right. So, sorry, mate. I'm just talking over it.
Yeah, for what?
We've got a couple other things going on. Well, we're not choking on the taste of beef. We're boiling up some water because we're going to make some gravy any second. And just in the fire here... Foz, if you'd like to help us out with this as well. We've got some veg on the go. So if I can just put me in the little way. So we've got some carrots here. Don't look very carroty from that side, but you turn them around, you can see there that we've cooked them, and that just peels off nicely. And you've got a nice tasty carrot there underneath. If you want to have a root around, mate, for the rest of the bits and pieces we've got.
some lots of spud though. We have got some jerky cooking in here as well. That's what this little shelter's all about.
Spud. Onions, mate.
Onions cooked in nothing but the skins they come in. Some spuds just wrapped in a bit of tin foil. I'm missing an onion still somewhere.
Missing in action.
There he is. Hiding. So there we go. The onions will be nice and caramelised on the inside. The potatoes are roasted.
Right, if you don't mind, I think we'll pinch that for the veg. Oh, they're lovely and soft, they are. Proper soft. Yes. Excellent stuff, right. Well, I think if you could leave us to it just for a moment while we can prepare our excellent feast, and I think we'll show you the results in just a moment. So I'll see you in a sec.
Cheers, guys.
Right, folks, so if you just want to have a little closer look, this is our veg now. So we've just took the foil off the spuds there, lovely and done. The carrots, they burn a little on the outside, but all you do is you peel that off, and then you're left with a nice soft carrot there to be cut up. And the onions, all you do is you break off the skin that you cooked them in. Look at that, a lovely caramelised onion. And believe me, that's going to make some great eating. So we've got those, we're going to finish preparing that. And once we've got the gravy on, that'll be the final shots of our epic meal out in the bush. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I'll see you in just a minute. Right then, guys, so here is the finished article. If you have a look in there, so I've got lovely tender chunks of beef just there. That's me tater. Me tater, listen to me. That's me carrot just there, I think. Cooked to perfection. It's just at a point where it's almost all a little bit crunchy, but it's not been overcooked. Wow, that's fantastic. I kind of want to have a bit of everything all at once here. Let's have some of this onion. Let me pick that up as well. Red onion, beef gravy. Match made in heaven, guys. So that's it. That's my pit oven there, and just a few little treats for myself cooked in the fire on top of it. Thank you very much for watching, guys. If you've got any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them down below. And if you like what I'm doing, give us a subscribe. All the best to you, folks. Take care. Bye bye. Right, folks. So tea is gone. It was delicious. We're just having a little brew before we get this lot cleaned up, and then we're out of here because we're losing light. And I have to say, Foz, it's been a pleasure, mate.
You too, mate.
Mate, absolutely enjoyed this. Top day, lots of filming done.
Plenty of good food. Productive.
And yes, most importantly, cracking food. I'm sure the cameraman agrees.
Go on.
So, yeah, here we are. Go on. Thank you very much for watching, guys.
Thanks, guys.